So this is our next example. Okay, I already have draw the circuit as well as the unknowns. Your unknowns are A, B, C, D, and E. And you try also to mark the nodes being 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Out of the 5 nodes, you need to select which one of these will become your reference point. The general rule for selecting the reference point is always select the point or the node which has the greatest number of branches that is connected into it. Piliin mo yung pinakamaraming branch na nakakonect dito. The currents A, B, C, D, and E are assumed directions of currents. Bahala ka ng mag-assume kung anong gusto mo. Okay? Before you attempt to formulate your equations, you need to analyze first in what particular node you will be applying your KCL, wherein you can reduce the number of unknowns, probably from 4, magiging 3 or 2. If you will try to apply your KCL at node 4, you will see that the two other branch currents are already given, giving you only one unknown. So if we start with a KCL at node E, or node E at node 4, summation of currents entering, all of them are leaving your node 4. So this will be 2 amperes plus 7 plus E, correct? 2 plus 7 plus E is 0. So your E is negative 9 amperes. So we already have one branch current that is obtained. And we are now ready to solve for the voltage at node 4. Remember that your branch current can be expressed in terms of the unknown node voltage, which is V sub 4. Because this is also equivalent to V sub 4 minus the voltage at the reference point divided by the resistance. V sub 5 is 0. So V sub 4 is equivalent to 2 times negative 9, and that is negative 18 volts. So out of the 4 unknown node voltage, 1 is already obtained. Nasolve mo na yung isa. So mula sa 4, naging 3 na lang yung unknown mo. That is V sub 1, V sub 2, and V sub 3. Okay? Next, we need now to apply your KCL at node 1. KCL at node 1. Summation of currents entering, isa lang, 2. Is equivalent to currents going out, A plus B. Or A plus B is equal to 2. Now, you need to express your A and B in terms of V sub 1, V sub 2, and V sub 3. Dapat may convert mo yung A and B into your unknown voltages na V sub 1, V sub 2, and V sub 3. So, your A, the easiest is, sundan mo lang yung direction ng A. The potential difference across your 2 ohms is the difference in voltage between node 1 and node 2, which is V sub 1 minus V sub 2 divided by the resistance in between plus B, the voltage in node 1, minus the voltage at the reference point, that is 0, divided by 4, and that is equivalent to 2. Combining now similar terms, 0.5 plus 0.25 is 0.75 V sub 1. 1 half is negative 0.5 V sub 2, and this is 2. This is equation 1. Okay, ganyan lang. Next is a KCL at node 2. summation of currents going into node 2, that is your A, plus your 3 amperes is equivalent to current going out, that is your C. So this is A minus C is negative 3. And doing the same, you need to convert your A in terms of B sub 1, B sub 2, and B sub 3. So your A, dito ang umpisa, i-minus mo yung voltage doon sa terminal point, i-divide mo yung resistance, 2. Minus your C, which is the voltage at node 2, minus the voltage at node 3, sundan mo lang yung direction ng current, divided by the resistance of 6 ohms, and that is negative 3. Okay? Simplifying, that is 0.5 B sub 1. So, we will now have 0.5 plus 1 over 6. 0.5 plus 0.167, that is 0.667 minus 0.667 B sub 2 minus minus 0.167 B sub 3 is negative 3. That is equation 2. So you already have two equations. And the third equation will be derived by applying your KCL at node 3. KCL at node 3. Summation of currents entering, C plus D plus 7. And that is 0. Or C plus 7 is negative 7. Or C plus D rather. C plus D is negative 7. Okay? So what is C? B sub 2 minus B sub 3 divided by 6 ohms plus D, 0 minus B sub 3 divided by 8, and that is 7. So if we try to combine similar terms, this is 0.167 B sub 2 minus 0.167 plus 0.125, that is 0.292. 0.292 B sub 3 is 7, negative 7. That is equation number 3. And you can solve this easily using your calculator. 4 B sub 1, B sub 2, and B sub 3. Okay, so for B sub 1, B sub 2, and B sub 3, and from the second equation, third one, okay, this is B sub 1 is 26 volts approximately, B sub 2 is 35, B sub 3 is 43.993 volts. This will now be your answer. Okay? Aside from this, in the board exams, the use of calculators that has the capability to solve 3, 4, linear equations, most especially if your calculator is Casio, is prohibited. Okay, bawal. Hindi pinapayagan ng PRC. By now, you should be able to solve a given system of linear equations manually. So, yun ang gagawin natin. No? Sulat na lang natin dito. That is 0.75 bisub 1 minus 0.5 bisub 2 is 2. Ito. 0.5 bisub 1 0.667 bisub 2 plus 0.167 bisub 3 and that is negative 3 and the last is 0.167 bisub 2 minus 0.292 bisub 3 is negative 7. So the value of V that we have here is 26 volts. So the next thing that we should be doing is, let us try to solve this manually. Okay. So if we will try to solve this manually, we will be using your determinants. Okay. So I hope that in your grades 11 and 12, na-discuss sa inyo yon, no? Yung matrices and determinants.